Hello, my name's Dr Rebekah Okpoti, and this evening, it is the 7th of April 2022, we are premiering Anne Lister's organ sonata here at Halifax Minster with Her Ensemble. Her Ensemble are the UK's first women and non-binary string orchestra. It's fantastic that they can join us tonight in concert.
We're going to be playing some Hildegard von Bingen, Florence Price, Caroline Shaw, some Lily Boulanger, and Alma Mahler.
All of the works being performed are being played by females, and all of the works that are being performed and actually played are by women composers as well.
So we're here celebrating Anne Lister's birthday week. Anne Lister was around in the 1800s, and she wore top hats
and suits. And I think she was an advocate for change and sort of questioning gender.
Yeah, gender stereotypes. Yeah. So we formed just over a year ago. I stumbled across this statistic that in 2019, just 3.6% of classical music pieces performed worldwide were written by women. And that really shocked me, having been through music school, music college, the profession, and had never questioned why the majority of pieces I'd played were by men. And last year that percentage rose to just 5%. So we're shining a light on female composers from the past and working with current artists today who share our ethos.
As you know, Anne Lister is a key figure in the history of Halifax and Shibden Hall. She was a landowner, diarist, and lesbian and feminist writer. And we know from her diaries, they're published, you can go and read them, that there's many entries about Anne commenting on playing the flute and her regular daily practice of the flute, but also playing the organ. We know that Anne played both of the organs that are here at Halifax Minster. Her mother, Rebecca, writes in one entry that Anne would be paid £40 to play the organ one Sunday, which today's money would be about £3,000. So she must have been quite competent. Both of the organs here were built by Snetzler. So part of this organ sonata is using the original registration. So that's the original sounds and pipes that Anne would have heard. So it's like she's really here with us. We know that she's buried in the Minster, and we're able to listen to what she would have heard. And we're also able to walk around and sit in the stalls where she took her singing lessons from the organist at the time, Thomas Stopford. The organ sonata is in five movements. The first movement uses the French toccata form. The second movement is called flutes. And for the purposes of this performance, we have two flute interludes. That's so that, you know, we can hop from one side of the Minster to the other and make use of both of the organs. The third movement is called Fortunately Placed, and that is played on the Snetzler organ, the small chamber organ that lived at Anne's friend's house. The fourth movement is Anne striding around Halifax and all the places that she visited. It's to capture the essence of Gentleman Jack and all that Anne was, and what an impact she made on her local community just by strolling down the street. The last movement is called My Pleasure. You can interpret that however you want to. And it's a big finale, and it makes use of some of excerpts from Handel's Halifax hymn tune.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Rebekah, and welcome to the premiere of Anne Lister's organ sonata. So, we are very fortunate to have Her Ensemble that have come up from London to be with us, and we're also very fortunate that we can continue this evening. There's a few events about to be cancelled with COVID, etc. So thank you all for coming. Now, don't know if you know much about Anne Lister, Gentleman Jack, but she played the flute. She regularly documents in her diary practice sessions before and after supper, but she also played the organ. And she played the organs that are housed here. There's two organs. There's the large one over there, and then over in the side chapel here, there's a tiny chamber organ, both of which were built by Snetzler. So the organ sonata is going to be in the latter half. Her Ensemble are going to play first, so I'll hand over to them. But it's going to be a bit different because I like to do her own thing, and so we're going to do our own thing today. And, you know, today's the day, everything has to be Instagrammable and take your little selfies and videos, etc. So we want to invite you to walk around, because depending on where you're sat or stood, you're going to get a very different listening experience. Nowhere's really out of bounds. As far as you've got all of this walkway, there's going to be some flute interlude right at the back in the tower, so you can walk down that direction. You can come and stand in the side chapel about halfway through when the chamber organ's being played. You can stay where you are if you really want to, or you can walk all the way around and go and stand up in the high altar and watch and hear what's going on from the other side. So we really want you to make the most of the experience of the space. And, you know, Her Ensemble are obviously performing in the middle, and what we thought was quite poignant as well, you know, they're all facing each other, but I don't know if you see Gentleman Jack, there was a lot of looking over the shoulder, having to close doors, etc. So it's kind of, we're looking in on something very intimate, which is what we're doing when we're reading Anne's Diaries. So I hope you enjoy this evening. We should be about 45, 50 minutes, and enjoy yourself, and please, please have a wander around. Thank you.
She wrote her own encyclopedia and did all of her own artworks. A really incredible person. And this is like a meditative chant that she wrote. Thank you.
next piece is by Florence Price. She was the first African-American composer to have her work played by a major symphony orchestra and the first to be recognised as a symphonic composer.
Thank you.
next piece we're going to play is called Valencia, which is named, apparently it's a type of orange, and it's by Caroline Shaw, who, as well as being an incredible contemporary classical composer, she's also produced music for artists like Kanye West. She's big in the pop world as well. Hope you like it.
Thank you.
sign kids, our train got cancelled before, so we're going to have to hop off shortly, but we've got a couple more for you. This next one's by a composer that you might have heard of, Mahler, but it's by Alma Mahler, who's his wife, but also an incredible composer in her own right. She wrote hundreds of pieces of music, and actually stopped writing music as a condition of her marriage to Gustav Mahler. And then he actually had some therapy with Freud, and then after some therapy, realised he'd made a big error, and that she definitely shouldn't have stopped writing. This is based on a poem, and it's very beautiful.
Thank you.
Well, thank you all for coming. We've had a nice evening and some new music. And listeners, Sonata will be going around the country and recitals over this summer season. So thank you all for coming. I think there's refreshments at the back, and hope to catch up with some of you now and see you again soon. Thank you.
A big thank you goes to Halifax Minster for hosting this concert today. Also to Arts Council England Lottery Funding for funding the project, Calderdale Council, Halifax Organ and Choral Academy, Her Ensemble, and Professor David Baker for tutorage and overseeing parts of the project, and also to Liz Nightingale, our lovely flautist. Thank you.